Welcome to This Is My Architecture. I am Han, and today I am joined by Matt from Replicon. Welcome.
Hi, Han.
Before we get started, tell us a little bit about Replicon.
Sure. Replicon is a SaaS-based software company. We build a time tracking and project management solution, and we're hosted on AWS.
Awesome. So what does a typical user do when they sign up with you?
So a typical user, when they interact with Replicon systems, and we have that here in our architecture diagram as these users down here, they get onboarded and they get put into a shared multi-tenant system. That's this Aurora system over here. So when they access our application, they're going to be going through an API gateway, accessing a set of shared business logic, which is a combination of EC2, ECS, and EKS systems. And then ultimately their data will be stored in an Aurora system that is backed by Replicon's platform provided KMS key for encryption at rest.
So if there is a requirement for customers that has more compliant regulatory needs, what does that look like?
That's where we get to these enterprise users up here. The enterprise users tend to come in and require a little bit different security story than the more typical users. And what they'll do is they'll, within their own AWS account, provision a AWS KMS CMK, and they'll share that with our account through a CMK key policy. We'll end up provisioning dedicated data storage systems to support their needs. So this Aurora system will end up being encrypted with this KMS key.
So you pull the KMS key from the customer environment into the Aurora to basically encrypt the data, is that correct?
That's correct, yeah. So all of the data ends up getting encrypted at rest. When these enterprise users end up accessing the system, they'll still be accessing the same shared API gateway system and the same shared business logic components. But now their data is being stored on a separate database server. What we have down here is a system that we call our Inter-Infrastructure Intelligence, or I3 for short. And it's a Fargate-based application API with a DynamoDB backing store. And every time the business logic tries to read, write, or otherwise access the data systems, it's going to access the I3 system. It's going to ask the question, hey, I am customer A, where do I go to access my data? And that's where the business logic will end up being routed between the shared multi-tenant Aurora system or between the dedicated enterprise provisioned Aurora system.
Gotcha. And so with that, because they're using their own KMS keys, that really emphasizes some level of a shared security model, is that correct?
That's right. There's a number of responsibilities that come along with this. So first of all, is there's a higher cost involved with onboarding and bringing these customers into our system because we're going to provision dedicated Aurora systems, which have a high amount of overhead, and we're going to pass that cost along to the customer. But ultimately, they're also going to be responsible to make sure that they maintain and availability for this KMS key. If they ever do something like forget to spend or pay their AWS bill and we lose access to this KMS key, their data is going to be encrypted at rest in the Aurora system but no longer be accessible.
Gotcha. So truly a separation of concerns for compliance regulations, right?
That's right. So ultimately what they're going for when they onboard in this kind of system is the ability to manage and own this KMS key and have complete autonomy over it and therefore all the data that's stored in our system.
Well, thank you so much for going over your architecture. That's amazing how you're enabling a multi-tenant's capability to allow customers to retain control of their keys. So that's awesome. Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you, Han.
And thank you for watching This Is My Architecture.